His scorecard was not needed, you might recall. Lewis winning in five rounds. You can expect a lot of pressure from the body puncher Wayne Rigby. He's in no mood, having worked so hard to become champion, of letting it go here. But Brown will be equally determined to seize this second chance, this unexpected chance, at a different weight of becoming a British title holder. The challenger Brown then in the red trunks, the black and white of champion Wayne Rigby from Manchester. Good left hook there from Rigby. Rigby's won 10 of his last 11 after a checkered start to his professional career. Good left hook from Matt Brown.
Well, Brown's got height and he's got reach. He's got to try and use that, keep Rigby off balance with the jab and, you know, keep the hooks coming in. But I think we've got to look for a boxing contest from Matt Brown.
That last fight that Rigby had when he won the British lightweight title against the Scot Tanvir Ahmed was a hard one, and it was only 3 months ago. Good left hook again from him there. And Brown will certainly feel the extra weight of the lightweight's punch.
Well, I think in this fight, Rigby can't afford to be casual. He's got to be very aggressive, close the distance down, keep the pressure on Matt Brown. I think that's where he'll have most effect.
Boxing here for a title at one of the classic weights. This British Championship at lightweight dates back to 1891, when it was first won by Dick Burge. Since then, there have been great names like Dave Charnley, Jim Watt, Ken Buchanan, Freddie Walsh.
Good atmosphere for this fight. Luke Brown's brought an awful lot of support with him.
Yes, he's the local man from South London. Good body shots from Rigby. Something of a trademark for him. His left hook has been an effective weapon in this opening round. Brown trying to stay with him, punch for punch. Maybe not be on the back foot as much as he was against Charlie Shepherd.
He's seen some nice punches inside from Rigby.
Yes, the champion looked the sharper in that opening round. Dark and Glenn McCrory with you live from ringside tonight at the Elephant and Castle in South London. British lightweight championship action, and Wayne Rigby, the champion, starting well against Matt Brown. Glenn?
Yes, just that little exchange going in. Rigby getting through with the right uppercut. Been a decent start from both men. Brown trying to keep the long range, but Rigby getting through with the better punches in close.
Rigby in the black and white, the challenger Brown in red. First defence of the title, remember this, for Rigby. But in that fight he had for the British super featherweight crown at 9'4", Brown did show that night that he can handle non-stop pressure, because Charlie Shepherd is a real walk forward fighter. And that was a good shot by Brown, that left hand. It just made Rigby give ground for a moment.
This is a good right and left hook in there for Brown. I think he's got to try and fight from long range with sharp punches as Rigby comes forward. We know he can handle pressure, as he did that night with Charles Shepherd, but he's got to keep his boxing together well.
Neither of these two men are noted as heavy punchers, so you can expect a long distance battle between them here. Rigby's only got 3 KO wins in 16 fights. Brown, only 5 in 12.
Rigby looking for those big hooks to the body. That would be a good tactic for him to try and get close to the body, work Matt Brown there, take the strength from his legs.
Rigby's one of those fighters who's had to pay his dues in the business before getting a chance. He used to have to supplement his income by working in an abattoir until about 18 months ago. Been boxing since he was 8 years old, 16 years in total.
Job, he told me last week that he didn't like it all.
The abattoir.
The abattoir.
Didn't Rocky used to hit slabs of meat
in
the
did.
Film? Yeah, he did.
I think he did, yeah. Trying to get busier from long range.
Just the more effective work still coming from Rigby. Busy, 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 this champion. Trained by Bob Shannon. And decorator up there in the Manchester area with Aziz Daho, brother of the late British champion Najib Daho. He's doing a good job with Rigby. He's improving all the time and started well here. Welcome back with the news that Wayne Rigby seems to have a problem there with some kind of damage above the left eye, Glenn.
I guess they're working on something. We got a good shot of it there. Nothing became that apparent, but obviously they've got the adrenaline on there, so there must be some blood coming through. So some damage for Rigby at this early stage.
He has had a tendency to cut in the past. It's not a new phenomenon for the team, so they'll be fairly used to that. Black and white Rigby, red at the challenger Matt Brown. We've been talking about Brown's possible problems moving up to lightweight, 9 stone 9, but he did weigh 9 stone 10 and a half for a fight a couple of years ago. Does he look to be carrying condition at this weight?
Well,
he certainly
doesn't look as cut as Rigby does. Rigby looks in tremendous condition. He looks to have kind of a little bit of excess flesh, but you know, he's still big, he's still tall, and he has a big frame, so you know, he should be able to move up okay.
I think one of the factors in this fight may be whether Brown has got anything to stop Rigby on the way in.
Well, that's what he's got to be looking to do. As Rigby comes forward, he's got to be looking to be busy and catch Rigby coming in.
Brown did show some classy counter-punching against Shepherd, who, even more than Rigby, is just a walk-forward kind of brawler.
But Brown's starting this round quite well, just trying to get busy with the jab, with bouncing his legs, keep picking punches from long range, and really that's the key for him, using the straight punches, long punches, and just being very busy.
Rigby's corner may be a little worried that he's sustained facial damage so early.
Well, it just looks as if that's knocked Rigby off his rhythm. Maybe known he's got some damage, because he just hasn't got his punches together as well in this round.
Good right hand getting through there from Rigby. Maybe a hint of the inside of the glove about it. It looked a bit of a slap. There looks to be some blood now by the left eye of Brown as well. maybe to the side of the eye. We'll try to get a closer look at that for you.
Well, both these fighters have suffered cut problems in the past. I think it's no surprise if there is facial damage in a fight like this. But good punches going in from Brown, just getting his rhythm now.
Fight evening up in this third round. It's the best yet from the challenger.
Boxing coming up next Saturday. Prince Nassim Hamed defending his WBO featherweight title against Wilfredo Vasquez. Chris Eubank challenging Carl Thompson for the WBO cruiserweight title. And Herbie Hyde steps into the ring to defend his WBO heavyweight title against Damon Reed. For further information on this special Sky Box Office event, 0990-800-888.
And what an intriguing night of boxing that is going to be in a week's time. Meanwhile, live in the ring here at the Elephant and Castle, the British lightweight title on the line with Wayne Rigby in the black and white trunks defending for the first time against Matt Brown. Good right hand from him there, and the body punch too.
I'm sure Bob Shannon in Rigby's corner has told him he's got to try and get back in command here, just letting it slip in Matt Brown's favour and letting him be busy standing off. So Rigby, you sense, must have to come out in this round and start being busy, get control again.
On the night he won the title, that body punching worked for Rigby. He wore Tanvir Ahmed down and was very close to stopping him at the end of the contest that night. And again, he's making the body a specific target here.
He's going for that, just carrying his left hand rather low, Rigby, and being made to pay for that by some nice sharp right hands from Matt Brown.
Big right hand gets through from Rigby. Brown there, his defence let him down for a moment. Brown, who was taken to the gym as a child because he was regarded as too timid. He's disguising it well now.
He did the trick, you think.
Again, fine body shot from Rigby, who has this workmanlike way about him, and he's obviously grown in confidence from becoming a champion. That happens to fighters. Did you find that, Glenn?
Very much so. It gives you a great deal of confidence when you're a champion, when they put a belt around your waist. It, you know, really brings something else out. And speaking to Wayne Rigby earlier in the week, he said he's very confident. He felt great being champion. His training is going well.
The cut looks a bit worse by the left eye of Brown. It's beginning to seep some blood now. Rigby's damage is minor by comparison, almost invisible in fact now. Just dabbing away at the cut as well there, Brown. He's aware of it, and Rigby rams a right hand through. The champion has taken control again here in the fourth.
Yes, he needed to do that. He needed to start pushing forward more, Wayne Rigby. He's done that well in this round. There's been some good counters from Matt Brown, but that was a good round from Wayne Rigby, just getting control of the fight again.
That's Rigby's record. He lost on his debut as an 18-year-old at super featherweight himself. Then was beaten by John T. Kelly, Kelton McKenzie as well. Body shots landed in that round. Look at that, 13-2. Rigby is good at that form of attack.
Yes, he's got to keep the pressure on. He's got to keep going to Matt Brown. The body shots have worked very well for Rigby. Keeps whipping them in, and they're hurtful blows. Remember, he's been fighting at the lightweight limit. He will be the physically stronger.
Fifth round, and Matt Brown in those red trunks, just to remind you, needing another good round, you feel here. He can't afford to let Rigby pull away on the scorecard. Doesn't want to be playing catch up too much here, does he?
No, I think it's always going to be hard for Matt Brown to do that with the work rate and strength of Rigby. Brown has to try and match him, ball punch and throw more. That's how I've got it. Rigby just pulling away a 2-point lead on Mike Codd.
Those rounds have been relatively easy to score. I'd be surprised if referee Terry O'Connor had it much different than that. Very, very workmanlike and relentless, this improving champion from Manchester. He is the British lightweight title holder, but most neutral observers wouldn't regard him as the best lightweight in the country. We've got people like Billy Schwer, the European champion, who's with us tonight. Michael Ayers, who's on the comeback trail. Colin Dunn, who holds the lightly regarded WBU World Championship. Some good fighters around at this weight.
Rigby looks as if he's got his concentration. He's starting to lift that left hand up now. He was dropping it and was getting caught with Brown. Now he's starting to pick it up, and that's working better for him. Looking to get in close and work the body.
Brown fighting with that cut above the left eye. And it's the sort of cut that if it did worsen, the blood might run into the eye and obscure the vision. The tide is running against Brown at the moment, you feel?
Yes, it is. He's Rigby very busy looking to get in, and he's pushing Brown on the back foot too much. Brown's got to try and keep ring centre if he can and match Rigby for punches as Rigby comes in. He's not been able to do that.
Determined, intense display by Rigby. There's a rather tentative look about Matt Brown at this stage.
Yes, he just looks about, he's thinking about it too much. Good round for Rigby.
Welcome back to the Elephant and Castle Leisure Centre, not very far from Waterloo Station in London. And you're watching Wayne Rigby and Matt Brown in British Lightweight Championship action. Rigby's doing well here, and I think at the moment, you'd have to say, Glenn, he's pulling away.
Yes, he is pulling away. Another good round from him, looking strong. Matt Brown's starting to look very defensive, and Rigby's starting to get to him. These body punches must be hurting Brown.
This is better from Brown, much more assertive. Did look as if maybe his resistance was just starting to crumble around the edges in that last round at times, but maybe he just needed to get back to the corner and regroup.
Yes, I'm sure the corner have noticed that he looks as if he's weakening and being pushed back too much, and they probably told him, come out, you've got to do something. You've got to do something better. You've got to start pushing forward. We want you to start matching the punches when Rigby comes forward.
Neither of these two fighters have ever been on the floor in their careers so far. Although Brown was stopped in a round by the, well, now journeyman, Peter Buckley. That really was a blip on his record, which he's put well behind him now. And I think he has proved it to be something of a freak, to be fair to him. Says he wasn't properly prepared that night, rushed into the ring, that kind of thing. To take nothing away from Buckley. Good right uppercut on the inside there from Rigby. just does look a stronger man at the weight, doesn't he?
He looks very, very strong in this weight, although he says he can make it quite comfortably, and was talking to me about, you know, his ambition to go down a weight to fight Charles Shepherd for the super featherweight title. So maybe that is in his plans.
The cut looks to be worsening and deepening of Brown. It's still okay at the moment, but I just wonder if it's going to hold up, that eye damage.
Well, it does look as if it's getting longer, the cut, but the good thing is that they're stemming the tide of blood, which is always the big danger.
Moving through the weight business is quite interesting. We're going to see it spectacularly next week when Chris Eubank tries to become world cruiserweight champion, moving up two divisions to take on Carl Thompson. That part of our Sky box office presentation next week, with Prince Nassim Hamid topping the bill. Getting a little messy in this round. They touch gloves at the end of the round, and it's a good chance for us to bring in the views of Barry McQuiggan.
Yeah, and that's a very competitive little contest. It's still in the balance, although I have Rigby sort of getting out ahead now. He's now four rounds ahead as far as I'm concerned. He's four rounds ahead. But he's beginning to start to wear Matt Brown down. Brown is an unusual guy. He looks ropey some rounds, he looks like he's tired and listless, and then in the next round he comes back. But I think he's beginning to press ahead and establish his authority on Matt Brown, and I think that he'll continue to do that and possibly wear him down as the fight goes on. The problem with Rigby is he doesn't take enough time to concentrate on placing his punches. His accuracy is very poor, and he flails away at times, but he really has got to start placing his punches better.
Interesting observation that from Barry McQuiggan. Maybe suggesting a little more quality at the expense, possibly, of the quantity from Rigby. And this is what Glenn McCrory's scorecard says.
Well, I've got Rigby pulling away in a handy lead. It's good work. He's keeping busy. He's just it just looks as if he was starting in the fifth round to wear Matt Brown down, but Matt Brown come back quite well at the beginning of the sixth. But it's still an interesting fight, and Brown's still very cagey.
In plain terms, Brown needs something to stop the rot. He got in with a good right hand there. I just wonder whether Rigby wanted a split second to compose himself, and maybe doing him a disservice. Rigby is resilient. He might have lost three times, but they've all been on points, and they were early in his career.
Well, I think conditioning is a very strong point for when Rigby works very hard under Bob Shannon, using all sorts of different methods.
The eye damage just getting that bit worse again for Brown, as if he didn't have enough problems. That looked a low blow, which the referee, Terry O'Connor, actually didn't pull up, but Rigby was very, very sporting, held out his glove and said, "Sorry about that, mate." And there's a good spirit between the two of them.
Yes, the referee just caught on the blind side there, but Rigby did apologise.
And you're wondering at the moment, what has Brown got to win this fight with?
Well, he needs something special. He's got to try and find the chin of Wayne Rigby. He's got to shake him up for the tide to turn.
Brown will be just hoping, I think, to hang on in there, hope that maybe the storm subsides and he can come on a little stronger later on in the fight. But is that clutching at straws? It might be, you know.
Well, he's unable to keep his boxing together at this point. He had to try and rely on the jab, the straight punches. He can't really do that. It's getting close in. It's getting Rigby's type of fight, so getting easier for Rigby.
Everything going his way so far. His mum can't bear to watch his fights. She I told you the story. She didn't believe he was in a British Championship fight. That kind of brings a new meaning to that old phrase about not being a household name in your own living room, doesn't it?
It's difficult when your mother doesn't know you're fighting. I think parents are always like that. My father spent more time in the toilets when I was boxing.
I remember Charlie Magri's wife, the former world flyweight champion. She used to come into the arena and watch the fight, and then she'd have to rush out after about 10 seconds.
There's the low blow from Wayne Rigby. But he realized he'd done that. He acknowledges, says sorry, but I don't think that helped Matt Brown any.
I've only given Brown one round so far. What about you, Glenn?
Yes, I just give him the third round. Everything else I've given to Wayne Rigby.
Brown knows that he has to do something here to buck the trend, the pattern of this fight, but it's easy for Glenn and I to sit here talking about it. A bit harder for him to do, I would imagine.
Well, it's proving that way. I think the chance for Brown was to use his speed, use a lot of use of the ring, keep moving, beat Rigby to the punch, but really been good pressure from Rigby, and Brown hasn't been able to do that.
That's good from Brown. Three punch combination. That maybe will lift him a little. Seen fights before which have turned around dramatically in the second half. And a little rally from Matt Brown in this round.
Well, this is showing good heart, spirit from Matt Brown, trying to push forward, trying to take the fight to Rigby.
Rigby's work rate has just dropped off a little. Is a tough man who's had it pretty hard himself. He has a job as a self-employed building maintenance officer. He has to get up at 4 o'clock, do his running, go to work, then get off down to the Henry Cooper gym in the evening for his training with James Cook, the former European super middleweight champion. Tough life.
Well, this is the other side of the coin for the majority of boxers. That's the way their life is. They've got to go to work and put all the work in the gym and pound the roads, and that's very tough to do.
There's that wicked looking body shot again from Rigby. He found the accuracy there, digging them into the rib cage, and these may break the resistance of Brown. Rigby finishing the round strongly after Brown had a good start. And this scoring the round, you mustn't forget the first 1.5 minutes.
This has got to test the spirit of Brown, because he started quite well and Rigby's overcome the fast start of Brown and now pushing him back on the ropes. And I just wonder if he'll start to wilt under this pressure.
The fight has been stopped. Brown has no more to give. Rigby retains the championship. The end came suddenly. They looked, I think, at the eye damage, and I think they could see no way back in the contest. Rigby was dominating. Brown had snarled a last act of defiance early in that eighth round, but Rigby came back dominated him again and was a very, very big winner of that fight. It's only his fourth stoppage win in 17 fights, but he's improving all the time.
Yes, that was a good performance from him. I could just sense at the end of that round he was starting to wilt. He'd done well at the beginning of the round. Brown, Rigby matched him for that, pushed him onto the ropes, and there wasn't much coming back from Brown. You just got that feeling what it was like for him after he'd had that good start to be taking punches again. I could just sense that he was starting to wilt on the ropes.
Well, I think probably it was a sensible decision, because you couldn't see any way for Brown to win from where he was in the contest, and no complaints. And I think really it's a good decision. There are other fights for him down the road, and needs to maybe just save himself for that. He was not going to win at this weight. Denny Mancini there. Yeah, look, he's saying Denny Mancini is a very experienced operator. Frank Maloney too, they're saying he's had enough. That he's not going to win, and we don't want him taking any more.
We're very compassionate, because you know there's other fights. He fights another day, so I think that was sensible. There wasn't a way back for him. So, but nothing to take away from the performance of Wayne Rigby. Very good, good pressure.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the eighth round, Brown has been retired. Your winner, and still the British lightweight champion, Wayne Rigby. Well, sports fans, please show your appreciation for a very, very game boxer indeed, and a great challenger, Matt Brown.
So still British lightweights champion, and still unbeaten at lightweight, Wayne Rigby. Gutsy effort from Brown tonight, wasn't it? But perhaps the right decision, and made at the right time. Heavyweight action to come, so stay with us. But first, some reflections as Rigby collects his British Championship belt from the European champion, Billy Schwer, who's with us tonight. Billy.
Big win for Rigby. He was close early on, but he started to pull away midway through the fight. And Matt Brown just didn't have the strength or the ability just to hold him back. And he just kept coming forward with Rigby. It's a good win for him.
Back for a long time, and I think now's the time to retire. That two shots, like Frank, the most confident man in the NJS. Thank you.
Well, there we go. Thank you very much indeed. Matt Brown announcing his retirement, presenting the coveted Lonsdale belt to James. James Morgan will now present the coveted Lonsdale belt to Wayne Rigby.
Bound to be emotional, isn't he, Brown, at a time like this, in case you were just struggling to hear that. He has announced his retirement in the ring there in defeat. But unrestrained joy for Wayne Rigby, and the record grows and grows. One more of those and the Lonsdale belt will be his to keep, but for now he is just a proud holder of a British title belt, hoping still for better things. And both men are going to have a word with Ian Dark.
Wayne, congratulations, a first defence of the title. Glad to get that one under your belt, literally, with the Lonsdale around your waist there.
Yeah, I'm really glad to get out of the way. Matt Brown here, proved a great challenger. I mean, all respect in the world for him. You know what I mean? Loving to be at the end of the day, we're all best of mates, you know what I mean? And it's great, you know what I mean?
And still looking at it,
it's still beautiful.
Yeah,
get some pictures with it later.
Let's have a quick word with Matt. You've announced your retirement there, and it was a brave effort. How big a factor there was the weight differential? I mean, you're a super featherweight moving up.
Not really, I just didn't really have it in the tank. Lost a little bit of desire, that's why I come to the decision I should retire. I thought about it for a while. You know, my wife's just about to have a baby any day now. You know, maybe tonight. So I think it's time to move on and do other things.
Was that a factor in the decision to pull you out at that time in the fight?
No, I just didn't have it in the tank, and the cuts were getting worse. What's the point of going on? I was well behind on points. Congratulations to Wayne. Respect for him, you know. But Charlie Shepherd's still the top man. I'd like to say that.
He's the fellow you fought for the British super featherweight title.
A brilliant fighter. I'll tell you what, he's going to beat Peter Judson. I think he's the best fighter in Europe at that weight division.
Well, we wish you a happy retirement, and you've given some good value.
Thank you very much.
Let's go on with Wayne again. Wayne, where does your story go from here? You're improving all the time. Do you want to get in with the likes of Billy Schwer now, maybe Michael Ayers, Colin Dunn?
At the end of the day, Ian, I've still got a few more fights yet, you know what I mean? Because I've been out of the ring 10 months. It's my first two fights back. So I'll go for Lonsdale. Hopefully I get a warm-up fight again in about 6 to 8 weeks. And no, I mean, it's like I said to Glenn, no, I'm just taking one thing at a time first. My aim is to go for the Lonsdale belt, then sit back, then see how good I am then to go forward. You know what I mean?
I guess it beats working in the abattoir, doesn't it, this?
Yeah, it's a lot better. Yeah, really good.
Can your mum bear to watch your fights yet?
I know, but we're saying that. I mean, she's watched the video umpteen times, you know what I mean? But she didn't watch the fight, you know, the actual night. So it'd be the same again tonight, she won't watch the fight. Until she knows I've won, then she'll watch it again.
And maybe she'll believe you're a British champion now. Well done tonight.
Yeah. Can I just say a big thank you to my physio, Roy Orton, because I've had bad ankles lately, and I was lucky to come through the fight, really. So thanks, Roy. Cheers, mate. And can I just dedicate this fight to my mate, Peter Farnavis. He died a few weeks ago, you see, for the boxing. So big finger. It's a big fight for this. It's for Peter Farnavis.
Well said. You've said it. Thanks a lot, fellas.